God bless. Welcome.
Le damos la bienvenida al comisionado de la alcaldía de Nueva York para los asuntos hispanos. Hello. Tenemos intérprete todavía, o sea, para.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, sir, pero allá alguien está bloqueando una bomba verde.
Una guagua verde.
Es un Toyota que está bloqueando la guagua al frente con tablilla 1753.
Los que no entienden guagua es un vehículo.
Gigare, un vehículo. Se morirá, mi general.
Sí, porque esa palabra en algunos países no se entiende.
Because that word that I use.
Hay guagua en algunos países que guagua es muchacho.
Which wawa means children in another country or a child.
Pueden sentarse.
You may be seated.
Honorable comisionado, nos sentimos honrados.
Honorable.
De que esté con nosotros, que haya
sido. We are happy that you are with us today.
Este día para estar en esta actividad.
In order for you to be in this activity with us.
Esta es una reunión compuesta por líderes de diferentes condados, diferentes tractos.
This is a meeting from many counties, Connecticut, Southwood, Bronx, Queens, Manhattan, Brooklyn.
Vienen de Rockland County.
They come from Rockland County.
¿De qué otro sitio vienen que se me queda algún sitio? De Connecticut, ya lo dije. Del Bronx, de Manhattan, de Queens, East Suffolk, West Suffolk, Nassau County.
He mentioned all of us.
Así que nos sentimos muy contentos y muy privilegiados.
We feel very happy and greatly honored.
Quiero saludar la presencia de un hermano y un amigo.
I would also like to give a well welcome to a friend and a brother.
El señor Tapia.
A brother Tapia.
Es una persona que empezó desde que esto empezó y mucho antes.
Is a person that started this and started it before it was started.
Y gracias a Dios pues.
And thanks to God.
Otra vez
and he's coming back integrating himself once again to the organization.
Así que bienvenido.
Welcome.
Vamos sin pérdida de tiempo.
Without losing any more time, let's start.
A darle el tiempo que necesite. Para nosotros es un placer.
For us it's a privilege and an honor to give this individual the time that he needs.
Creo que es el primer pastor que ocupa esa posición.
It is the first pastor to, I believe that it's the first pastor to accumulate that spot.
Y para nosotros es de gran honra.
And to us it's a great honor.
Así que vamos una vez más a recibir con un fuerte aplauso.
Let a great shout of applause. Let's receive one more time. Thanks to the pastor and the general Luis Paniagua. Y'all may be seated.
Agradecemos al Señor por la oportunidad que nos da de estar aquí en este lugar.
I give thanks to the Lord for allowing me to be in this place.
Y hemos comenzado ciertamente hace dos semanas.
We have started, just started working 2 weeks ago.
El honorable alcalde de la ciudad de Nueva York, Eric Adams.
The mayor, thank you, Eric
Adams.
Adams.
Thank you. Como comisionado asistente de asuntos.
That he has named me as assistant commissioner
para la oficina de asuntos del inmigrante.
And on the office of dealing with immigrants. Immigrants affair.
Mayor's office of immigrants affairs.
The mayor's office of immigrants affair.
Estoy aquí acompañado con uno de nuestros trabajadores.
I'm companion with one of our workers, with Brother Maldonado. And there's a other brothers that are companioning me as well.
Queremos hablar un poco de lo que es la oficina para asuntos del inmigrante.
I would like to talk about the office of issues of immigrants.
Immigrants affairs.
Immigrants affairs.
En la ciudad de Nueva York tenemos alrededor de 3 millones de inmigrantes.
In the city of New York, we got over 300,000 immigrants.
3 million. Inmigrantes, de los cuales 1 million.
And out of all of those, 1 million
son hispanos.
Are Hispanics.
El trabajo de nuestra oficina es poderles proveer los servicios.
The work of our office is to be able to give the service
que la ciudad de Nueva York ya tiene.
Of the service to render
inmigrante.
During the pandemic, it was very important for us to notify the immigrants of our state
que ellos tenían la oportunidad y el acceso para hacerse exámenes gratuitos del COVID.
That they had accessory in order to take all the necessary precautions to take the SAMs for COVID as often as possible.
Y de igual manera tener acceso a la vacuna.
And also to have accessory in order to take the vaccination.
Todo esto es gratuitamente para ellos y no les afecta con su estatus inmigratorio.
This is all totally free for them and it does not affect anything of their immigration status.
Porque muchos de ellos piensan que si reciben esta ayuda de vacunarse le puede afectar en su estatus inmigratorio.
Because many of them think that if they take this vaccination that it might interfere with their status as citizens
or immigration. Todas las personas pueden tener acceso a un plan médico en la ciudad de Nueva York. Los inmigrantes tienen la oportunidad de tener acceso a un plan médico incluyendo servicios médicos a bajo costo o incluyendo planes gratuitos auspiciados por la ciudad de Nueva York.
And many times all these benefits by the city of New York is totally free in order for them to get the benefits that they need.
Y si no cualifica para su plan médico, puede recibir servicios médicos a bajo costo o hasta gratuito.
And if you can't qualify for your medical benefits, you can qualify for free access or at a low cost benefit to you.
Otro beneficio que tenemos es para aquellos que están pasando depresión.
And another benefit that we're going through that we have are those that are going through depression.
Tenemos también servicios para aquellas personas que por cualquier razón están sufriendo de problemas depresivos.
And this we have a program that specializes on the attention of those people that are going through a difficult moment with depression.
Yo personalmente tuve una llamada la semana antepasada.
Myself personally, not last week but the week before, had a personal conversation or a personal call regarding.
Que estuve enfermo del COVID y estuve internado por 3 meses.
I've been sick, but with the COVID, and I was internally for 3 months.
Esa persona estuvo internada 3 meses.
That person was in the hospital or in their place for 3 months.
Cuando salió, salió muy depresivo.
And when he came out very depressed.
Y sus familiares querían mandarlo a su país de origen.
And their family, his family, wanted to send him back to his original country.
Él no quería regresar porque él pensaba que todavía tenía el COVID y iba a infectar a sus familiares.
And he did not want to return because he felt that he still had COVID and he was scared to affect his family.
La situación es que no recibió la ayuda o la consejería necesaria estando disponible y penosamente este joven se quitó la vida.
And sadly to say that this young man was not able to get the proper needs and counseling that he needed and this young man took his life.
La depresión o problemas de salud mental existe dentro de nuestra población inmigrante. Nosotros tenemos que ayudarlos y tenemos los recursos para ayudarlos.
In between our own denomination and in between the immigrants in our own society, this affects us that it's a mental issue that's affecting our community and we have the access to help them.
Kevin, si tienes que interrumpirme en algo,
He's asking his partner if he needs to interrupt him with anything, that he's more than welcome to interrupt him.
De igual manera, educación por los inmigrantes.
As well as education with immigrants.
Todos los niños,
all children,
4 años en adelante,
from 4 years old up,
tienen la oportunidad para asistir a pre-K.
They have the possibility, they have the rights to assist pre-K.
Porque muchas veces los inmigrantes piensan que sus hijos no pueden tomar ventaja de estos beneficios de pre-K.
Many times immigrants believe that they don't have the rights to assist, or their children to assist pre-K.
Y en algunos casos, hasta para niños de 3 años en adelante, en algunas partes de la ciudad de Nueva York, también se aceptan niños de 3 años en adelante.
And in many cases, in the city of New York, there's places that accept children to pre-K starting at the age of 3.
Y esto es un beneficio grande para los inmigrantes, porque número uno, se ayudan al niño a llegar al grado que debe estar para cuando ya empiece el kindergarten.
And especially this benefit, he'll be a step ahead of us.
Y de igual manera ayuda a las madres solteras o a la familia, porque en vez de tener que quedarse en la casa cuidando, puede ella ir a trabajar. Mientras su niño está en pre-K estudiando y aprendiendo.
And this benefits especially the single mothers or the family dynamics, because while the child is in pre-K already starting school, that mother or that family member can already start working and help the dynamics of the family.
Y todos los niños de los inmigrantes,
and all the children of immigrants,
tienen el derecho y la responsabilidad.
All the children of immigrants got the responsibility and the resources
y la obligación
and the obligation
de estudiar
to study
desde pre-K
from pre-K
hasta que tengan 21 años
until all the way to their turn 21 years of age.
Y es importante porque en muchos países cuando llegan a los 14 años los sacan de la escuela.
And it's very important because in many countries, once they reach 14 years old, they take them out of school.
Y nosotros tenemos que dejarle saber a nuestra comunidad de inmigrantes,
and we need to know, let our community of immigrants, let them know
que en este país los niños tienen que estudiar, aunque se vean grandes, tienen que estudiar.
And even though they may look big in this country, they have the right to study all the way until their 21 years of age.
Y dicen hasta los 21 años.
And they say up to 21 years old.
Viene a este país con 14, 15 años.
And they say up to 21 years old because many immigrants come at the age of 14, 15 years of age.
Y por el idioma muchas veces se atrasan en su educación académica y tienen el derecho de permanecer en la escuela hasta los 21 años.
And many times, just because of the barrier of the way that they speak English, sometimes they fall behind and they have the opportunity in order to reach their goal of learning the language up to 21 years of age.
De igual manera, hay otro programa que se llama Speak NYC.
And there's another program that is also spoken, it's called Speak NYC.
Este es un programa para que adultos que ya hablan un poco inglés puedan comenzar a estudiar un inglés más conversacional.
This is for adults that are already have a little bit of English in order for their English to grow and they can study higher education in the English language.
Así que hay muchos programas para que nuestra gente aprenda presencialmente y virtualmente.
There's many programs in order for us to go in person as well as online.
También tenemos el programa de alimentación de emergencia.
And we also have the program of giving food banks by emergency.
Dentro de la pandemia, mucha de nuestra gente inmigrante eran trabajadores y trabajadoras esenciales.
During the pandemic, many of immigrants were necessity workers and
essential
workers. And therefore, this benefits them.
Ese 75% estaba trabajando y no había problema, estaban ganando su dinero, aunque estaban arriesgando su vida, pero estaban generando ¿verdad? Su pan de cada día.
And these people were, you know, at least 70% of them were working through the pandemic and making the bread that they needed to make in order to take care of their families daily.
Pero el 25%,
but the 25%,
y ese 25% no tuvo ningún tipo de entrada durante el cierre de la ciudad que duró tres meses.
But that 25% of the people were closed in and they were not getting the benefits that they were supposed to be receiving for the 3 months that they were locked up down.
Hay un programa en la ciudad de Nueva York para darle comida gratis a personas que hay comida vegetariana, comida para personas que comen comida kosher, que son las comidas que comen los judíos, o comida también halal para aquellos que son musulmanes.
And through this person, we have vegetables and fruit for those that are vegetarians. We have kosher food, which are those for those that are Jewish, and we have halal food for those that were Muslims.
Y simplemente lo que tiene que marcar es 311 y decir get food.
And all you have to do is mark 311 and say receive food.
Eso es todo lo que tiene que hacer y ahí.
And that's all you have to do, and automatically the ball will be rolling.
Porque aunque usted no lo crea, mucha gente pasó hambre teniendo la ciudad de Nueva York servicio y recursos para poder ayudar a nuestros inmigrantes.
And many people went through a difficult moment suffering of hunger because they did not know that these services were.
El problema mayor que tuvimos dentro de esta pandemia.
The major issue that we had during this pandemic.
Cuando un inmigrante moría,
when an immigrant died,
inmigrantes querían ser repatriados.
Due to when an immigrant died during the pandemic, it seemed like you got to repeat that because if people talk, they get.
Ellos querían ser repatriados. They want to be brought back to their country.
Okay. When an immigrant died during the COVID situation, they also wanted to be sent back to their native countries.
Pero muchos países no aceptaban personas que hubiesen muerto del COVID, ¿no?
But many of the countries were not receiving that body for the simple reason that they were not receiving anybody that died due to COVID.
Y muchos de ellos tenían que enterrar a sus seres queridos aquí en los Estados Unidos, lo que sabemos que es costoso.
And many of them had to bury their loved ones here in the United States, and we know that it's very costly.
Y el programa de la oficina que yo trabajo se llama Mayor's Office of Immigrants Affairs, se le llama Moya por su abreviación, pero no tiene que ver con nadie que se llama de apellido Moya, simplemente esas son las abreviaciones.
He said the organization that I represent and the office that I represent is due through the mayor's office and it's called Moya, but it doesn't have to do with the name of anyone. It's just that's the way that they abbreviated it.
Correct. Y a través de esta oficina, personas que han muerto del COVID o de complicaciones por el COVID podían recibir, si califican, hasta $9,000 para sus gastos de entierro.
And if any person that went through this and had to go through that issue of getting sent to their native country, they have the opportunity to reach up to the benefit of $9,000 for the cost of their funeral expenses.
Y todas las demás personas a través de HMH tienen derecho hasta $1,500 para ayuda final o ayuda de tanto fúnebre. Toda persona que muere aquí en la ciudad de Nueva York de una u otra manera tiene la oportunidad de recibir hasta $1,500 a través de HMH.
And every family that had a family died due to COVID. Okay. Anybody that dies in the state of New York City of any kind of complications due to their final cost of the final price of the cost of their funeral, they can qualify up to $1,500 for that funeral expense. And according to the nutrients, we also have that program.
También hay un programa de protección en contra de la discriminación.
And there's also a program that has to deal with against racial profiling.
En la ciudad de Nueva York no se tolera ningún tipo de discriminación contra nadie.
And it's in the state of New York, and there's no racial profiling, and it's not acceptable against no ethnicity at all.
Incluyendo a los inmigrantes que son indocumentados. Ellos también están protegidos de la discriminación o de acoso.
And especially to those that are immigrants and they don't have papers, this also applies to them, that they have the rights to be protected and not be racially profiled.
De igual manera, protección contra la violencia doméstica.
And same way for domestic abuse.
Sabemos que muchas de nuestras nuestros inmigrantes están siendo víctimas de violencia doméstica.
And we know that many of our immigrants are being abused domestically, and we are focused on that.
Y violencia doméstica es abuso contra el esposo, contra la esposa, contra el hijo, contra un hermano, contra un cuñado. Todo lo que sea doméstico y que haya abuso es violencia doméstica.
Any kind of abuse in the family is considered domestic abuse, whether it's abuse against the husband, the wife, the children, or anyone in the family dynamics is considered domestic abuse. And the flyer, you can call 1-800, that's on the number.
621-HOPE.
It's called
621-HOPE. 621-HOPE.
621-HOPE.
Y ahí están, en el flyer están todos los números y son diferentes números para que usted vaya rápidamente a donde usted verdaderamente quiere recibir ayuda.
On the flyer that you have or the pamphlet that you have, it has many numbers that indicates each program that's in the thing. That way you can go directly, immediately to the spot that where you need the help at.
De igual manera, derecho como inquilino.
You also have the rights as a renter.
Muchos de nuestros inmigrantes sufren abusos de parte de los propietarios porque piensan que no tienen ellos derechos.
Many of our immigrants are going through abuse by the people that are renting them or the owners of their building for the simple reason that they feel that they don't have rights.
Una experiencia de las muchas que yo he tenido con inmigrantes, en una ocasión, una persona se atrasó 3 días en pagar la renta y cuando llegó, le habían cambiado el candado y le habían tirado todas las cosas a la basura.
A personal thing, out of many things that has happened to myself, there was an immigrant that he was not able to pay the rent for 3 days, and after the third day, when he came home, there was the locks were changed, and all his furniture and belongings were thrown out on the street.
Si usted tiene problemas con su con el dueño de su apartamento, usted también puede recibir ayuda gratuita de parte de la ciudad de Nueva York para enfrentar ese problema.
And if you're going through this issue, you also can come through our department and through the Department of New York City, and we will also deal with that issue as well.
Y o llamar al 311, donde también lo van a referir rápidamente al lugar apropiado donde usted tiene que.
Or you can also take the initiative and call 311, and they will direct you exactly where you need to be directed to.
Otro asunto que los inmigrantes no saben es que ellos tienen derecho a pedir una licencia por enfermedad y ser pagado por su patrón.
And they and also many immigrants do not know that they can ask for a license to drive. And because of an illness that they may...
Licencia para ausentarse del trabajo por enfermedad.
Okay, that he may get a license in order to be pardoned from the job that they're functioning due to their medical illness.
O por alguna otra razón.
Or for any other reason.
Y debe o tiene que ser pagado por su patrón.
And they need to or they should be paid by their bosses.
Tiene que llamar también al hotline que tenemos ahí para saber si la persona califica.
And you also have to call the hotline that's on that paper in order to see if you qualify.
De igual manera, servicio para gastos finales o gastos fúnebres para víctimas del COVID.
And also to close up, for those people that have died or passed by, but I didn't know that it was my person.
En verdad esto, agradecido, no era necesario, estamos para servirle, de verdad que sí.
He said that basically it wasn't necessary for this recognition, that he is happy to be of service.
Y estamos tratando de hacer lo mejor. Vamos a tratar de hacer lo mejor dentro de la posición que nos han colocado.
And I'm going to try to do the very best during the in the position that they have placed me in.
Pero el obispo mencionó algo sobre las personas que están atacando los trenes.
Our general says something regarding the people that are being attacked on the trains.
Es prioridad del alcalde. Yo estuve reunido la semana pasada en alcaldía.
It is the mayor's main focus, and I was together with him just last week.
Sacar a todas estas personas, los deambulantes que están viviendo en los trenes actualmente.
His priority, thank you. His priority to remove all those homeless or less unfortunate that are hanging out or living in the subways.
Pero dándole la ayuda que ellos necesitan.
But giving them the help that they need mentally.
Y es importante que ustedes también sepan que hay una oficina que se llama.
And it's very important that you guys know that there's an office that is called
Oficina de Fe y Community Partnership.
That is called Faith and Community Partnership.
Que son los que se encargan de ayudar a las organizaciones sin fines de lucro.
That is the one that's in charge of helping those organizations that don't have the funds.
Con los fondos necesarios para crear todos estos tipos de programas.
With the funds that are necessary in order to build these foundations for these programs.
El director ejecutivo de esta oficina, que es la que se encarga de esto.
The director that's in charge of this office, that's in charge of this office in this department.
Es también un pastor que se llama Hill Monroe.
He is also a pastor, and his name is Hill Monroe.
Y su senior advisor fue recientemente nombrado el pastor Fernando Cabrera.
And the one that was, if you guys talk to me in the middle of him talking to me.
El senior advisor de esta oficina recientemente fue nombrado el pastor Fernando Cabrera.
And he was assigned by Fernando Cabrera.
Fernando Cabrera fue asignado como su asesor principal.
And he was brought up to be his financial advisor.
Esta oficina es la que se encarga.
And this office is the one that takes care of.
De ayudar a todas las organizaciones sin fines de lucro.
It is the one that organizes and strengthens all those organizations that don't have the funds.
El papeleo necesario.
In order to provide the necessary paperwork.
Para conseguir los fondos.
To get the funds.
Estas actividades.
And be able to make these creations for these activities.
Así que yo lo voy a comunicar con el ex concejal Fernando Cabrera para que lo ayude en este proyecto que ustedes quieren desarrollar.
And he says that he's going to help us, Fernando Cabrera, to help us with this vision that we have in front of us.
Porque hay muchos fondos.
Because there's many funds.
Para que se puedan ayudar a las comunidades.
In order to help our communities.
Y cuando se hacen estas propuestas, que se le va a ayudar a usted a hacer estas propuestas.
And when there's this offer on the table, in order to help our communities, for like mental health, drugs, and all that, it gives us a greater benefit through these companies. And you can tap into those funds and go to the director of the community. There are people that are assigned to this office that will be able to deal with this issue. I'm so grateful. I know him for many, many years. In 2000.
En 2003.
In 2003.
Cuando nosotros fundamos Radio Cántico Nuevo.
When we started Radio Christian Sing.
Cántico Nuevo, sí.
New.
El locutor que nosotros empezamos fue Benjamin Cascos Jr.
And the first foundation was
primer locutor.
The first broadcaster was
Benjamin Cascos Jr.
Benjamin
Cascos Jr.
That name.
Y él era miembro de la iglesia de Luis Paniagua.
And he was a member of our general church or congregation, Luis Paniagua. And that is the time that I met the bishop. And we worked very hard in the march as well. And we made a lot of stops with Angusta and with our other
drummers. Gracias, tenemos que salir para otra actividad que tenemos ahora.
Thank you, but we have to leave to another activity that we have.
Vamos a estar trabajando juntos.
And we're going to be working together.